Okay, let's need another YouTube. Ada chemical reactions untuk alkin lagi. Kita still untuk alkina. Okay, dengar sini we have so far undergo, we already learned about combustion and polymerization. We have another 5 to go. We have another 5 to go, guys. Okay, actually, the next one will be hydrogenation. Penghidrogenan. Penghidrogenan. Guys, from the word itself, dari perkataan itu sendiri, kita dah tahu dah sebenarnya kita tambah apa?
Hydrogen.
Very good. Kita sebenarnya tambah hydrogen gas. Tapi kan guys, there are some tricky part over here. Some tricky things, eh? Kita ada C double bond C, H, and H, and H, and H. Of course, we are taking the same stuff. Then, tambah dengan H2. Guys, tapi reaction ini will never take place as it is. You need certain catalyst, monkey, and temperature in order to enhance the chemical reaction. Apa maksud saya? Catalyst yang perlukan untuk tindak balas ini will be, you must use either platinum or nickel. Platinum or nickel. Syarat dia 180 degrees Celsius. Kalau tak ada benda ni, reaction ni tak akan berlaku. Guys, as you can see over here, H2. Maksudnya ada 2 H lah kan? Dia ada 2 H. Okay? H, dash, H. So what happened guys? This one will attack over here. And this one will attack over here. Then you will get C double bond C, H, H, and H, and H, and H, H, and H. Guys, is this right?
No.
Is this right? No. What is the problem?
5.
Carbon only entitled to have how many bond? 4. Jadi 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Saya pandang 1. Jadi rupa-rupanya hydrogenation, penghidrogenan adalah satu proses di mana it bertukar jadi ethane. Ini adalah indirectly what I'm going to tell you adalah yang ni adalah hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon tak tepuk, dia jadi tepung. Inilah proses kita kadang dipanggil sebagai saturations of this ataupun proses untuk buat margarine. Inilah proses kita buat margarine, eh? So we make it from unsaturated become saturated. Guys, the next one I'm going to tell you will be halogenation. Among the car, from the word itself, you already get a clue. Halogen. I'm referring to group
17.
Very good. Group 17, which is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. But for halogenation, we prefer to use of the chlorine and bromine due to the reactivity. Disebabkan kereaktifannya. Very simple, and you must understand all those stuff are exist in the form of a diatomic. Maksudnya adalah dalam bentuk dui atom. Okay, dui atom. Okay, dui atom kan? Apa yang berlaku? Dia ada C double bond C and H, H and H and H. Tambah dengan Cl2. Okay guys, yang ni kamu tak perlukan apa-apa catalyst or temperature. You can directly react it is. Where you know it is Cl and Cl, you go here and here. Then again you get 1 H and H and Cl, C, H and H and Cl. Double bond saya dah buang. Okay, therefore, guys, from ethene, actually, it changed to 1,2-dichloroethane. From a unsaturated, it become saturated. Ini adalah cara tindak balas berlaku. But guys, do not confuse ini dengan substitution, penukar gantian. Dalam proses penukar gantian alkana, kalau kamu nak berlaku benda ini adalah mesti dengan kehadiran UV. Ini tanpa kehadiran UV, di mana indirectly what I'm trying to say, kalau kamu nak differentiate between alkana dengan alkina, the best one adalah halogenation test. Halogenation test lagi precise, bromination. Okay, so guys, stay tuned for the next video.